This is the Drummond household. Adam speaking.
Hello, this is the Tynan residence. This is Jacinta Tynan speaking.
Hello, Jeremy Black speaking. 444-910-525-563.
Yeah, we did. We were told by Mum and Dad that you had to answer the phone a certain way, and in our case, it was we had to say.
My mum had this etiquette that she taught us about how to answer the telephone.
This is the Drummond household. Adam speaking.
Yeah, g'day. It's Tim Ross here. I was just wondering, can you tell me about the time before mobile phones?
My mum and dad are from Sri Lanka. All of us were around trying to talk to our grandma as our family, and it's like, oh my gosh, that's my memories of those phones.
So we had the old rotary ones. I remember it being a beige kind of phone, like when we had the dial phones. I remember it being beige colour.
And then a dial phone, rotary sort of ones that used to sit on the table, like the old 70s style.
And I remember when the family got the press button phone, it sounds like something out of a M. Night Shyamalan movie, like in The Village or something. We were just like, we're finally caught up with society.
And then they were later, it wasn't so cool afterwards because we had those replacement touch phone ones from Telstra.
You've gone from the black wrench to something that we can actually touch and makes us feel normal.
Not all phones were created equal.
Mounted on the wall. The wall phone. And I have this memory of a white phone on the wall. We were very advanced. We got the phone on the wall.
All in the kitchen, so you had to stand up to chat to anybody.
And so it meant that when you talk on the phone, you had to actually stand there. That was the only problem.
And I think my auntie still has one at her house in Padstow Heights.
How about some stories about public phones?
In the neighbourhood phone box.
We used to use a public phone all the time when we were kids.
Yeah, I remember we had the old red phone at school.
The mandatory thing that you would do when you went to a public phone booth as a kid was check the change. Even if you weren't using it, you just check the change slot to see if you could get a free 40 cents or something out of it.
The amount of etching in the side that kids had put in with coins.
The trick was, on a boring weekend, to run up there with your, I think it was about a 20 cent piece, maybe even less earlier on.
The curly phone cord would just, like, if it moved at all, it would just crackle. And you'd never hear anything coming from the other side.
The big thing for us as kids was working out a way to make free phone calls. And there was always someone who knew that if you hit the star twice and then put in 10 and then the hash.
And you'd make the prank calls. Is Mr. Wall home?
I wonder if anyone's brother or sister or mum or dad listened into phone calls.
When you've got so many kids in one house and you're all sharing one line before we got two lines, you always have this fear that one of your siblings is going to be listening in, or worse, mum or dad listening in.
The other thing was mum and dad had attached a second phone.
Yeah, it was always difficult in my household to have a phone chat with a mate because my brother and sister would always constantly eavesdrop.
You'd be on the phone and you could actually hear the kind of click of, you know, really subtle of this other line being lifted up.
But mum cackles, right? So she's cackling to you. Of course we did. We loved listening to you guys talk to your friends all your bullshit.
So you constantly have this dialogue of like, I know you're there.
I think it was one double night where you caught dial a number and it would ring back. And so us kids would do it all the time to him. We'd be like, what the bloody hell are you doing, kids? You know? Sri Lankan accent.
Can someone answer that phone, please?